first met Bobby Vee was just a kid, of course. He was what we used to call in the old days a teenage idol. And the lovely part about it is, as he's matured, he's just gotten better and better and better. And to this day, the girls still love him.
I'm having a great time. It's amazing after all these years, and I still get to go out and work with people that I, with some of my rock and roll heroes. I mean, Chuck Berry and Little Richard and Jerry Lee Lewis and Duane Eddy and, you know, some of the great performers that started rock and roll. And I was, you know, lucky enough to be amongst them in the early years. You know, started out when I was 15 years old. I mean, not a way that I would have chosen to start my career, but filling in for Buddy Holly and Richie Valens and the Big Bopper at the Moorhead Armory, 1959, February. And it was a, you know, turning point in my life. I mean, there was no reason in the world why I should have been there. I was just at the, you know, I was in town and they were looking for acts to fill in the evening. And there was a guy in the audience that was sort of the local show business agent, the manager kind of thing, and a week later he was managing us. And in June of 1959, went in and recorded some songs that I had written, and by September of 59, I had a number one record in the Upper Midwest on a regional basis. And then I signed with Liberty Records out in California, and that was really the beginning of my recording career.
Bobby went on to record over 30 albums, charting 38 songs in the top 100, with 14 hit records reaching the top 40. He received 6 gold records and a gold album for individual record sales in excess of 1 million copies. As a matter of fact, Billboard magazine called him one of the top 10 most consistent chart makers ever, with classic gold records like The Night Has a Thousand Eyes.
Has a thousand eyes.
And the timeless number one record, Take Good Care of My Baby.
Just tell her that you love her. Make sure you're thinking of her in everything you say and do. Take good care of my baby. Now don't you ever make her cry.
My wife and I have 3 sons. Jeff, Tom, and Robin, they're in my band. So I've been told it's the best looking band I've had. But they're also great players, and they grew up with the music, and it's probably the most authentic reproduction of my music that I've had in recent years, because my son Tom plays a stand-up bass, and it's like the old rockabilly days. He pours it up in the air and spins it around, and Robbie's just a great rocker, and on the Gretsch guitar, and great singer and writer, too. And Jeff is the lays down the foundation for the band. R. Stevens, another guitar player in the band, has been with me for 20 years, and Greg Armstrong, keyboard player for about 5 years. I have a daughter, Jennifer, who's a graphic designer and does a lot of our album cover, CD covers, and has a business of her own. And of course, the anchor of the whole situation is my wife, Karen. She's we've been married for, just celebrated our 33rd wedding anniversary. A few months back, I tried to get her to celebrate the 33 and a third anniversary. I thought, hey, I'm in the record business, you know, this would be fun, this would be different.
Come back when you grow up, girl, you're still living in a paper doll world.
Achieving international success, Bobby and his band have consistently played to sold-out houses around the world, delivering a show that is fresh and exciting while being an authentic tribute to the golden era of rock and roll.
It's been great for me to be able to travel around the world and be in different cultures and also to have my family with me. We were in England for the Buddy Holly Memorial Show a couple years ago. Paul McCartney invited us to come over, and last year over in England, Andrew Lloyd Webber invited us to come over and play for his Sidmonton Festival. And it turns out, you know, he grew up with my makes me feel old, but he grew up with my music. And had all my records, so it's just a great feeling traveling around.
If you found another guy who satisfies you more than I do, run to him, I'll step aside.
At the early days of rock and roll, it's it's great, I guess. You know, as old as we are, we're all still young enough that, that there's still a lot of rock and roll heroes around. And I just did a show with Dick Clark a couple weeks ago. I work with him from time to time, and he is the eternal teenager. And I sometimes forget that he, you know, without Dick Clark and without the impact of American Bandstand, you know, we kind of smile about it these days. But it really was such an important show, and he had played such a large part in launching rock and roll through American Bandstand and his dedication to it over the years. So he's a dear friend.
The Bobby Vee Family and Friends Show is sure to delight audiences of all ages. Backed by a top-notch band that includes Bobby's three sons, this show combines the old with the new, delivering true to the record renditions of Bobby's and other classic 50s and 60s hits with the energy and dynamics of today's top performers.
50s and 60s music just seems to belong to everybody, and people come in and have such a good time. It really is family entertainment, and there's sort of an energy that happens around the show. So I'm having a great time in my life right now. It's, you know, kids are all grown up, all out of the house, and we're rocking.
It's a magical rock and roll night to remember.
As much tomorrow, whoa, whoa, love you more than I can say.
Oh, one last kiss, oh baby, one last kiss. It never felt like this, oh baby, not like this. You know I need your love. Oh, 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 give me one last kiss.
Give me one last kiss.
Oh, one more time.
For the day so it might as well rain on till September. Yes, it might as well rain on till September.